You ready, bro?
I think it's finally time.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm super excited to be here. I'm Isaac, and this is Adit from AMD Gaming. Today, we got a super, super special announcement from AMD. We're launching the Ryzen 7 9800 X3D series processor.
These CPUs are fantastic. They're built on our same Zen 5 architecture that we've been talking about our past few episodes, but now with that sweet second generation 3D V-cache.
Tell me a little bit more about how the first gen differs versus the second gen.
Yeah, so our first gen 3D V-cache technology, that was introduced with our 5800X3D CPUs, our Zen 3 CPUs. And if you have an AM4 platform and you're looking for a drop-in upgrade, 5800X3D is still a very capable CPU for any gamers. Yeah, still one of the best. I think for that platform, you can't go wrong. Now, with that first iteration of 3D V-cache, it was organized in a way where we had the die, the cache, and then we had, you know, the IHS, the cooler on top. And this here allowed us to get that massive boost in performance and get that significant amount more cache for your games. With our new generation of 3D V-cache technology, we quite literally flipped it on its head. So we actually have the cache sitting below the dies now. The dies and cores are now raised a little higher, so then we get direct contact with the cooler. So you're getting higher speeds, better frequencies, better cooling, better efficiency, and overall just a better experience out of this product.
That sounds amazing. We've said so many better things, and the CPU really is not even just better, but the best. It's the king of CPUs. If you're a gamer, you gotta make sure you get your hands on this CPU.
Now, what's great too is this isn't just for gamers, right? 7800X3D, 5800X3D, it's always been, you want 3D V-cache, you know, get that if you're a gamer. If you're a content creator, you need the cores and threads of some of our higher Ryzen 9 SKUs. This time around, with this new format of organizing the cache and the cores and our cooling, this actually lets us get higher frequencies. It actually lets us get better efficiency and performance overall. And what this means is you're actually able to sustain higher clock speeds across all those cores and threads for a longer duration of time. So if you're a content creator that needs cores and threads and sustained performance, say you're doing video editing, photo editing, any type of content creation, these new CPUs with this upgraded configuration for how it's laid out internally, you actually get much better performance in multi-threaded workloads versus our previous generation.
That's right. What's also great is that you're able to fully overclock the CPU, meaning that you get that full power and full juice out of this great product. And it's the first time you're able to fully overclock a CPU that has 3D V-cache.
Yeah, so in the past with our 5800X3D and 7800X3D, you had access to some high-level overclocking through the means of precision boost overdrive. So, you know, undervolting and, you know, any type of quick work in Ryzen Master. Now, with these new CPUs, you get full control. So you go into Ryzen Master or even use the auto OC in your Adrenaline software. You're actually able to fully overclock the CPU. Now, if you guys are interested in how to, you know, min-max your system, you know, optimize your system with overclocking, you know, using some of our featured Adrenaline software, leave a comment down below and we'd love to cover it in a future episode.
That's enough talk about the Ryzen 7 9800X3D CPU. I can't wait to put this in my machine and rip some Call of Duty.
Oh yeah, well, I don't want to burst your bubble, but I already have one at home and Call of Duty runs fantastic on this CPU.
I cannot wait.
So Call of Duty Black Ops 6, in case you missed it, that launched last week. We have a blog out, we have a video out. Make sure you check the link down below for all the details on Call of Duty Black Ops 6 and our partnership together.
If you're thinking, wow, the Ryzen 7 9800X3D is pretty sweet, but it looks like there's a bit left in this video, well, your observation skills are great.
Yeah, today we are so excited to cover AMD Fluid Motion Frames 2 officially in our driver.
That's right. If you update your AMD software to the latest version, you'll be able to get the power of AFMF2 right within your system. And what's great about this feature is that there's much improved lower latency, way better performance, and great visual quality.
Now, if you haven't heard of AFMF before, just at a high level, this is our driver-based frame generation technology that brings this technology to thousands of different games across, what, DX11, DX12, and Vulkan now?
That's right.
That's insane. So
OpenGL.
Oh, and OpenGL. So, hey, if you want to play Minecraft, there you go.
Now, I remember when you were using AFMF, you experienced something called Fallback. Tell me a little bit more about Fallback.
Yeah, so the way how AFMF works is you have frame generation. However, when you have fast-paced movement, the algorithm will actually turn the frame generation off to preserve image quality. Now, for me personally, AFMF1, I found the technology great, but if I'm playing like a really fast-paced game, like say I was playing Starfield and, you know, I'm like flicking around trying to, you know, shoot everyone, I kept finding that AFMF would turn itself off, right? So I didn't get the benefit there. Now with AFMF2 having, you know, these new search modes and being able to customize that fallback, I feel like the experience overall has been so much better with this technology.
Exactly. When you open AMD software and you go into AFMF2, you'll see two new modes. First one being the search mode. What the search mode does is that it reduces the amount of fallback significantly so that your gaming experience is much smoother at various levels of different resolutions, whether it's 1080p gaming, 1440p or higher. What's awesome with this search mode is that if you set it to auto, it'll be able to adjust the fallback and adjust these settings automatically, and you don't need to touch anything. However, if you're looking to fine-tuning your performance, you're more than welcome to fine-tune those settings as well. The second mode that we're introducing is a new performance mode. Now, what performance mode does is that it'll lower the overhead of frame generation to your system, especially in those integrated and mobile GPU configurations. And even coming into handheld support soon, it'll lower that overhead to bring you a greater, smoother, and better visual experience overall.
So when you're saying smoother experience, are you referring to input latency, or are you referring to like just on screen, like how smooth the frame looks?
How about both?
Okay. You get
much lower latency. You'll also see higher visual quality on screen and visual smoothness as you're playing. So you'll be able to fully immerse yourself in those games, whether you're playing on PC, laptop, or handhelds.
That's awesome. Like just from my brief experience trying it the other day, like I love it. Like it's pretty sweet.
I can't wait for more users to be able to use this.
So if you checked into our last episode, you remember we introduced a new segment where we checked out some awesome products from some great partners. I think we should go do that again. Let's do it.
If you remember from our last episode, we got to review the awesome ASUS ProArt laptops. Great laptops for creators who are on the go and looking for that packed performance. In today's episode, we'll be reviewing the ASUS Zenbook S16. Now, the ASUS Zenbook S16 is the first in ASUS ultra-thin 16-inch Copilot Plus PCs. It weighs only a little over 3 pounds, yet it's packed with performance, starting off with AMD's Ryzen AI 9HX370 processor. With the new Ryzen AI chip, you'll be able to take full advantage of the power and performance from this ASUS Copilot Plus PC. Running the latest Ryzen AI engine, you'll be able to get up to 50 TOPS of power-efficient performance for the latest AI applications. In addition to this, the ASUS Zenbook S16 has a beautiful 3K OLED display and 6 surround speakers, giving you that full immersive audio and visual experience. Also, you'll be able to get up to 18 hours of battery life with just one full charge on the ASUS Zenbook S16, not to mention that you'll also have all the ports you need: HDMI, SD card reader, USB-A, USB-C, and of course, the audio jack. If you're looking for a laptop that's powered by AMD Ryzen AI and combines prestige, performance, and power, the ASUS Zenbook S16 is a great choice for you.
And that wraps up this jam-packed episode of AMD Now Playing.
We had so much fun talking about this episode and also using the products and features that we talked about. The Ryzen 7 9800X3D CPU is the king of CPUs for gamers, and so we can't wait for you to experience it. If you like this video, hit that like button, and if you like winning your games, hit that subscribe button. If you want to stay up to date with what's happening at AMD and AMD Now Playing, hit that notification bell so that you're in the know. Until then, Adit,
we'll see you on the next episode of AMD Now Playing.